Really, Kevin? You know what? You know what, Kevin? I can see this is no coincidence how all of a sudden I get served. You're here in the audience. So why don't we kind of cut the shenanigans and why don't you come in the ring, security, let him in the ring, get him a mic, okay? And we can talk about what I'm holding in my hand face to face because you obviously have something to say. Get him a mic. Let him over. Let him over. Hey, 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 hey. Let him over. Whoa, slow it down, guys. Okay. Get him a mic. Okay. Get him a mic. Let him in the ring. Let him in the ring. Really, Kevin? You know what, guys? This is going to be all right because we're going to talk about something. You guys can step out. Step out. I got to talk man on man. Really? What you guys don't know is what I'm holding in my hand after just glancing at it is the largest wrongful termination lawsuit in history. Where is, if Kevin Owens wins, he would be awarded $25 million. That's a very big number, Kevin. Very big, and you are obviously swimming where you shouldn't be swimming right now. Kevin, I look at you.
You know, you want me to talk. Maybe you should shut your stupid mouth and listen, you dumbass.
Oh, really?
You know why? Because ever since I came out here several weeks ago and I said out loud what everybody's been thinking about you for years, which is that you have ruined SmackDown by making it your personal playground. Now, You've been targeting me. You've tried to make my life a living hell. One example, after SummerSlam, you fined me $100,000 for beating the hell out of your crooked referee, Elias. Yet, what happened? You're right, I shouldn't have put my hand on an official, right? What happened last week when I was the referee for your match against Chad Gable? Let me see. Oh, you couldn't get the job done. And then you attacked me from behind like a coward. You laid your hands on an official, which is exactly what you fined me for. You fired me on the grounds that I was being insubordinate. Insubordinate. See, that's where my case rests. That's where my case lays, is the fact that I wasn't being insubordinate. Actually, it was quite the opposite. Because that fine you held over, that $100,000 fine over my head for weeks. And finally last week I swallowed my pride. I thought of what was best for my family. And as sick as it made me to do it, I did exactly what you wanted me to do. I tried to help you. I tried to help you beat Chad Gable. And you still couldn't do it. You lost. You know why? Because you tapped out. You tapped out! You! I've tried to reason with you. I've tried to fight you. Last week, I even tried to help you. But now all I want to do is hurt you. But I finally realized that the best way to do that is hit you where it hurts the most. And that is your wallet and your pride. So Shane, make no mistake about it. This is about a lot more than money. I have a case, and you know it. I can see it in your face. I have a legitimate case. But I guess you didn't read those papers very thoroughly, because it's not just about taking millions of dollars away from you, which is going to feel great, but there's another clause in there. And that's when I win. I get to come back here, stand in the middle of this ring, and look at you dead in the eyes in front of the entire WWE universe and say, Shane McMahon, you're fired!